so that when you collect, you don't have the risk of that he puts down the back too much. And he has to arch the back. The back has to be arched in a round way. Good. Engage the hind legs again. Oh, easy, easy. You don't want a quick response. You just want a fluent response. So you don't have to hurry him. You don't have to kick him, unless he's not responsive to your leg. Then you can use your spur. But normally, just activate him with your leg a little bit more. Activate him. Good, good. And then collect him again fluently. But determined. Be determined about the collection. Pick him up a bit. Good. There you go. There you go. That's what I want to see. Good. Self carriage. Good. Change reins once again. And do it the same on the diagonal again. Slightly forward, slightly back. But make sure the response is quick enough. So be determined about what you want. Good. And then collect him again. Up. Up. Easy. Relax your hand. Good. So first you have to get the response. So you make a half hold. And he responds in coming back on the hind legs. And then you have to relax your hand again. You can keep the contact, but you have to open your hand a little bit. Good. This is very nice. This is a very nice balance. Good. And when you have that balance, that's the point where you can decide to go a little bit forward or a little bit back. But you have to start, every time you ask for a response, you have to start at this point, where he's in self-carriage, where he's light in your hands and light on your leg. That's good. And keep him forward. There you have to engage him a little bit, because now he was really nicely uphill. And then once you lose the impulsion from behind, he starts to go down a little bit. So the first response was really good. Good, very nice. Take him back again. Up. Nice. Keep him forward. Good. Good. That's good. So you have to, the intention is to ride him forward with an uphill tendency and to take him back uphill with a forward tendency. So yeah, good. Up with a forward tendency. Very nice.